All right, men, welcome to today's episode of Strong Men, Strong Marriages. What to do when your wife criticizes you? So this is a common thing guys experience and are not sure how to handle it. You know, do I just listen to it? Do I fight back? Do I, you know, what do I do here? So we're going to give you some good strategies today for this. So my name is Mike Fraser, MD. I'm a psychiatrist and marriage coach. I help high-achieving Christian men have more intimate marriages. So some wins from guys in my program, Strong Men, Strong Marriages this week. Guys are experiencing more hugs from their wife. Their wives are more attracted to them. They want to be around them more. It's great. Wives are expressing gratitude for feeling heard and supported by their husband. This one's huge, building that mental and emotional intimacy. Guys are having fun, you know, going on dates, enjoying time together. Wives are expressing gratitude for the service and things that their husbands are doing. Okay, one of the great ones I got this week, right, was guys are just feeling an increase in positive energy, like more positive energy than they felt in a long time. A lot of times marriage can feel like roommates, strained, upset, all of that. So guys are stepping out of that into that positive, more fun energy again. Guys are finally feeling free from that mosquito cycle, doing the right things for the right reasons, being able to say no to things sometimes, you know, do those, just step out of it into strength. So cool to see. For me, my wife and I had a really fun date night this week. Enjoy doing that each week. And then had, you know, some intimate conversations around parenting that we're going to get into today. So to start out with, what is criticism? So criticism, it's to find fault with or point out the faults of someone or something. So if your wife tells you that you did something wrong, okay, first of all, that might be criticism or it might not, right? I mean, if she's pointing out a fault, like, okay, you did this and that was not right. You are a bad person for doing that. Okay, maybe that's criticism. But sometimes she might just be saying, hey, like, you know, the way that you didn't turn your turn signal on, right? That actually is illegal. So maybe she's right. And that is wrong. Okay. So is she pointing out a fault? Yeah, kind of. Is she doing it to be mean? Maybe, maybe not, right? Or maybe your wife tells you, hey, you folded the towels wrong or you washed the dishes wrong. These are things I've heard guys tell me their wife will, you know, criticize, say, there was a fault in that. You didn't do it the way that I wanted, which again, you got to be a little bit careful and say, well, is she really saying I'm like morally wrong for doing it this way? Or is she just saying like, I want something different? Okay. Or your wife brings up your past mistakes. Okay. You did this, you had an affair, you looked at pornography, you weren't trustworthy, you didn't keep your word. Okay. That is pointing the faults out. So yeah, that could be considered criticism. So yeah, depending on what she's doing, could it be considered criticism when she's pointing out your faults? Yes. Okay. And so it doesn't feel good to be criticized. It doesn't feel good when your wife tells you what it feels like is you're not measuring up, right? You're not measuring up to some standard that she has for you. And that can feel bad, right? But one of the things we've got to remember is just holding on to our own self-worth here. You know, that's what cures the mosquito cycle, is being able to hold on to your own self-worth. We're going to talk about some other strategies too, about filtering out and that sort of thing. But a lot of guys, again, it's not easy to hear these things. And so a lot of guys respond to criticism by getting defensive. So their wife says, oh, you didn't fold the towels the right way. Okay. And the guy's like, well, I'll fold the towels however I want. I don't care what you think, you know, get defensive. So, or they'll point out where their wife is also feeling, oh, I'm not folding the towels right. Well, you know, you didn't take the trash out, or, you know, you never have sex with me and that's not being a good wife or whatever. Right. So they'll respond to criticism by criticizing back, by pointing out her faults. Okay. Or they'll try to fix all these mistakes to try to earn her approval. Okay, honey, yeah, let me fold the towels right. Okay, yeah, you know, you didn't, you thought I spent too much money on this. I'll never do that again. Okay, let me just do everything to make sure you're happy and satisfied with me and that you like me, right? That's the mosquito cycle. And usually these responses don't turn out very well, okay? They lead to more fights, they lead to little progress, and you just get the same patterns over and over. But yeah, these are the common responses to criticism: getting defensive, getting aggressive, or, you know, just trying to fix it to quote unquote make her happy. Hey. So, and then what it leads to is that mosquito cycle, right? So, you feel like if she criticizes you and you try to fix all of it, then yeah, she's gonna finally like you. She's gonna appreciate you, give you affection, attention, sex, all of that. But then she doesn't, okay? And you start getting frustrated, and that's when you're gonna go into these other ones where you get defensive. You're like, well, I'm not gonna do anything anymore. You kind of check out. You're gonna criticize everything I do. I'm not even gonna try, right? Quiet quitting on your wife. Or you get more aggressive with it, you explode, right? You say, well, I'm doing, yeah, maybe I'm not folding the towels right, but you're failing in these other big areas. Okay. And so then you feel bad about it. You start kind of trying to earn your way back into her good graces, and it just perpetuates that cycle over and over. So what do you need to do instead? What are the steps you can take when when your wife is being critical, when she's pointing out something that you're doing wrong? Okay. Or a flaw, right? Something that you're doing that's not right. And again, kind of distinguishing and using that mental filter. Is this actually something that, I do need to improve as a human being, that I want to be a better man, and she's pointing that out? Or is this something that, is just her own preference that I don't really need to agree with or not? We'll get into that. So again, if your wife's criticizing you, one of the first things you want to do is breathe, right? Take a break, step away. A lot of times we get into that fight or flight mindset when we feel attacked, when we feel criticized. Our sympathetic nervous system, that fight or flight mode, it kicks in. And so we want to freeze, or we want to fight, or we want to run away. It's understandable. It just doesn't turn into anything very productive. So take some breaths first. Bring your thinking brain back online. If you need a break, just let her know, hey, I just can't really have this conversation right now. I need to take a break. The other important thing to do in here is to identify what the request is, or help her to identify that request. So with the towels example, she's like, oh, you fold the towels wrong. Hey, finding the request in there. Okay, well, is there a way you would like me to fold those towels? Right? Helping her see. She's like, well, I already told you. Well, just show me again. I just want to understand how you would like these towels folded. Okay. So again, criticism, it's a form of complaining, and there's a request behind it. So we're trying to get to that request. And look, usually that request is coming from a good place, right? So giving your wife the benefit of the doubt. Maybe there's a reason she wants the towels folded this particular way. Maybe she just likes it. Maybe it helps her feel more at peace, right? So you want to try to understand, what the request is, the reason behind it. Okay, try to understand that from her. So take some time to get that understanding. Okay. And then the last thing you can do is decide whether you're going to honor that request or not. Some guys forget about this. So just because your wife wants you to fold the towels a certain way doesn't mean you have to, right? You can tell her no, that you're not going to. Okay. You can tell her, hey, like, I'm happy to do other stuff. I'm not going to fold the towels that way. That's up to you. And it's within your power to say no to some of her requests, right? You just have to figure out, like, the type of husband and man that I want to be. Is this a request that I want to honor or not? But again, when she's criticizing you, try to see through it to what is she actually asking for here? And then, am I going to honor that or not? Okay. You never listen to me. Okay. That's a complaint. That's a criticism. Okay. That's pointing out a fault that you have. So again, what's the request there? The request is to listen, right? So you could say to her, okay, yeah, I hear you saying that. I think what you're asking for is you want me to listen to you more. Is that right? It's like, yeah, that is right. Okay. And then you get to decide, are you going to honor that request or not? I'd recommend honoring that request. I think that's a good one to honor. You could say, yeah, I think that's a fair request. I want to do a better job of listening to you. So again, this is how you go from feeling attacked, right, to helping your wife reframe it into what she actually asking for. Because look, it's not super productive for her to just point out everything that's wrong with you, right? It's not. And so your job is to try to find out in that, what is she asking for, and then decide, okay, am I going to honor that request or not? So I'll give you an example from just last night. My wife and I, so my son and I got into something at the dinner table. I was not being a great parent in the moment. I really wasn't. So, you know, just getting upset with him, getting angry, said some mean things to him that really were not accurate and not representative of who I want to be. So, you know, my wife criticized me, you know, said there was a fault there, that that was something that was not, not right that I was doing. And I felt myself definitely in that fight or flight mode, definitely more towards fight in the moment. So I needed to breathe. I needed to calm down. I needed to get away. And so, yeah, my wife and I, we kind of went to another room. I was able to get to a better place. It took me a while, to be honest. It took me a while to get to a more calm place. But then, yeah, we were able to get to, okay, what is the request here? And some of that was just a conversation, right? Expressing her concerns, me expressing my concerns, you know, and what we landed on was what she really wanted was to be able to set an appropriate consequence for him, but without the anger and like over the top emotional explosion that I was having. So look, that's a good request, right? And so it's something I do want to honor. It's something I do want to work on. So going through these steps, right? Calming down, being able to have the conversation, getting to what was she actually asking for from me, and then me determining, okay, yeah, that is something that's in line with who I want to be. That's a request I want to honor for sure. You know, I can do that. If there's a situation where things like she's expressing or hurt about the past, you did this to me, you hurt me, you had the affair, you looked at pornography, you know, you were never there for me, all of that, right? A lot of times the request in there is for you to be able to just kind of be with her in that pain. And so in that moment, a fair question to ask is, hey, listen, I hear you saying that. I know I hurt you. You know, what's help for you right now? Just for me to be with you, to understand this? Are you, you know, asking for something different for me to change over time? Or do you just want me to really get how much that hurt you right now? Again, trying to figure out what's the request here. Okay. Now, if it does get out of hand, you know, you can say something to her, you know, she's like, yeah, and I hate you. And, you know, I never want to be around you and you're the worst husband ever. And like, if it just starts being mean and abusive, right, you can set a boundary on that, right? You can just say something like, hey, listen, I do want to hear you, but I really can't when you use those kind of words towards me, or when you use that tone towards me, you know, I'm just not able to listen and be here when you're in that frame of mind, right? Then you separate, you let her calm down, you calm down, and you have that discussion again later. Because again, it's not good for you to be emotionally elevated and having these conversations. It's not great for her either. So just honor that for both of you, right? This is where it comes to loving her and loving yourself. You love both, right? So it's not right for you to just harp on her about everything she did wrong. It's not right for her, just harp on you about everything you did wrong. So try to get to that request, okay? Because look, it's not wrong for her to be able to let you know, like, that you hurt her, right? And you being able to just see that pain and be like, yeah, you know, I did hurt you. I'm so sorry. You know, I can see that now. And of course you're hurt by what I did. You know, that's a fair request, and that's an important thing for you to be able to do. And sometimes there's going to be some anger with that, right? And sometimes you need to weather it, and sometimes you need to draw the boundary, right? And that's just kind of feeling that out over time, okay? But again, you don't, if she's getting over the top, totally mean, you know, yeah, it's fair to set a boundary there. Just be like, yeah, listen, I do want to hear you. I want to listen. But when you're in this tone or when you're using those kind of words, I really can't. And so let's calm down and have the discussion later, all right? So again, the key in all of this is to think to yourself, what is she asking for here? What's the request? Because when there's criticism behind that, somewhere there's a request, whether that's to just kind of listen to her, whether that's to do something different. So just help her identify what that request is. Okay. And then again, you can choose to honor that request or not, depending on the type of guy and husband you want to be. Okay. You don't have to say yes to everything. So what do you need to be able to do this, to handle it when your wife criticizes you? You really need some internal emotional management. You need to be able to walk away and take some breaks when you need them. Okay. and identify when your emotions are rising to the point that you can't really do that. You also need the ability to filter out what's true and helpful and what isn't. Okay. So yeah, if she's saying a lot of things that just are not accurate, you need that ability to have the mental strength to say, okay, you know, some of this is just her emotions talking and some of it is accurate. And, you know, what are the things that I can take here? What are the requests she's making? Which ones can I honor? Which ones can I not? Okay. You also need some humility to see where you can improve instead of getting defensive and point out all her problems, right? You need the ability to communicate well with your wife. That's what a lot of this boils down to, is how do we have these tough conversations, but in a calm way that actually gets to something that we both feel good about. You need to understand requests and boundaries, understand what it means for her to make a request of you. How do you ask her for things you want? How do you set boundaries? Meaning decide what you're going to do or not do, what you're going to listen to and not listen to. And how do you turn conflict and even criticism into more connection? Okay, that's what Elizabeth and I were able to do just, last night. And, you know, it turned into something really positive. And for Thursday thoughts, I'm going to talk about, like, when is it actually criticism? When is it not? And being able to, like, tell that difference. So, but you can learn all these skills, manage your emotions, communicate well, you know, stay strong in who you are, have these tough conversations, create more connection, and bring that fun and flirting intimacy back. Even if there's a lot of criticism right now, you're going to learn the skills to deal with that effectively. So you can learn all that in the program, Strong Men, Strong Marriages. I invite you to come join. If criticism's an issue in your marriage, which is in most marriages, learning to deal with that effectively and turn it into more connection. So come join us, visit strongmenstrongmarriages.com, fill out an application. We'll get back to you with the best next steps. And again, there's a link in the show notes as well. All right, stay strong, men. We will see you next episode.